1985 at the movies. It's really an outgrowth of a series of concerts that I have been producing, celebrating film music and our great composers around the world now for many years.
I've done a fair amount of conducting of many of these composers. Horner and Broughton. I played for John Barry several times, a lot of times in the late 70s and 80s. It's a great thing that Varèse and Bob Townson are doing this, because it's something that's not really celebrated enough.
It's unprecedented. This never happens. It's a celebration of the great scores and composers of that year, everything celebrating its 30th anniversary.
I mean, it's amazing. Jerry Goldsmith did several films. We're doing one of the scenes from Rambo, a scene from the movie Legend that he scored, but it's only on the European version, the music that he did.
I wanted to have it be as representative as possible, as diverse as possible. I really like the idea of either giving composers an opportunity of rethinking and reimagining their own film scores and creating a concert suite.
I used to work for Michael Kamen, and he was definitely one of my mentors. And Bob called me and gave me the opportunity to arrange one of my favorite pieces of Michael's, the suite from Brazil. To get even crazier, it's actually on his birthday that we're recording this for the first time here in LA, which is pretty amazing. Anytime I get to reconnect with Michael's music is an amazing day for me.
It's the availability of music that is often the hurdle. With Quincy Jones's Color Purple score, we have a special arrangement that was actually done by John Williams, written as a piece for violin and orchestra, specifically for Itzhak Perlman. And this is the first time it has been made available.
Think about all the scores in that one year, Back to the Future. The Goonies, Brazil. It's like the perfect storm of film music in the 80s. Nothing like this has ever been done. We've never done a CD that's this one year that's sort of kind of ridiculous in terms of how much amazing what we would all consider, you know, here's the Goonies right here, what we'd all consider legendary film music. It's really a wonderful era and kind of sends chills up the back of your spine.
All of us essentially want the same thing. We want to be able to perform it live.
All the film score fans may know this, but I think there's a whole group of people who may listen to the CD and go, wow, that's what film music can be. It doesn't necessarily just have to be, you know, really intense action. It can have these beautiful soaring themes and these small moments. It can have jazz, it can have, you know, Latin, it can have saxophones. Great film music brings you back. It makes you sit right in that theater again in that very moment in time.
It really is a great celebration of composers we all hold so dear that made such a contribution to the art of film music and our culture.